What's up, what's up? My name is Javier Nunez. Yeah, well, the reason I'm here in Tokyo is for the G-Shock's 30th anniversary, you know, skate jam, festival, party, you know. So I'm excited to be here. Well, my connection with G-Shock was, I'm good friends with Ken. He helps, I think, the marketing in New York. Always invited me, Steve. From Frank 151, Malbone also plugged me in. Like when they do little G-Shock, you know, interviews or little stuff, they always, little projects, they, you know, they ask me. So, you know, that's how I got connected with G-Shock, through those guys. And it's cool how, you know, it goes from that and we end up meeting each other and we come out here, you know, on some other stuff too. So it's just, it all connects. I grew up in New Jersey, in Bayonne, New Jersey, but then I skated. I would go to New York to skate, you know, because the scene was bigger there for skateboarding. So like 10 years old, it was my first time going to New York. So I would go with my friends from New Jersey. And then once I, you know, I met a lot of friends in New York when I was young, you know, when I did the 411. Then I started meeting all these people and I started staying in New York. To me, you know, I was young, so to be part of that era, I was very, very blessed to be around these guys because, you know, like everybody from New York was just top pro in New York in the mid-90s, and, you know, they were my friends too, so at the same time, you know, I looked up to them, but also they were my friends, so that to experience that was pretty dope. And same with Supreme, you know, that was the place we all hung out. So we go meet at Supreme and then go skate downtown, the Banks, you know, Battery Park. We just, that's the place, you know. It's still like that to this day. That's what's so dope about Supreme. We have that. It's that underground skate culture, you know, it's still alive. You go to any Supreme, New York, LA, Japan, Shibuya, like you see, you know, the culture is still there, you know. And you know, growing up around all these special people in New York that were from New York, you know, I got to learn a lot. You know, I was young, but I had to act like I was older because if I act like a kid, even though I was a kid, these guys didn't want to hang out with me, you know, so I had to act mature, you know. I was like 11, 12. So yeah, I was real young when I did Kids. It was just pretty much, it was all our friends. Everyone in all the scenes was people we knew in downtown Manhattan. Oh, they were from all over, you know? You know, I had all my friends that live in the Bronx, Brooklyn, Queens, they all come to the city to skate. And those are all my friends. Just, that's what we did, you know? We really did that in real life. It was like the movie was imitating our life, you know. At a house party, smoking, drinking, chilling. You know, we really did that. So it wasn't hard. It wasn't hard to do. It wasn't a hard role. You know, he's having sex at the end. Casper's having sex and I'm on the couch. So, you know, I smoked so much that I fell asleep. I was really sleeping, like, on the couch while they were doing the scenes. And they wake me up in the morning, like, it's 7 in the morning. They're like, oh, you finished, you can go home. And I wake up like, oh, what happened? Like, you done, you slept the whole way. So that was funny, just being sleeping during the whole time we're filming. So it wasn't hard acting the kids at all. Growing up, you know, I would always stay in Justin's house in Brooklyn and in Harold's house in Lower East Side. So, you know, I was around these guys a lot and, you know, they were like older brothers to me. They always, you know, take care of me, you know, they always took care of me. And Harold too, you know, I learned a lot of jokes just being around Harold because he's a funny ass dude. And he always used to make fun of me. So, you know, I had to get my snap game up to fuck with Harold. But, yeah, just during that time, you know, I got to learn a lot from these guys. And if it wasn't for them two, I wouldn't be in Kids or none of that, you know. I wouldn't want to act. After Justin Pierce, you know, rest in peace, passed away, I was like, you know what, I could just you know, why not pursue it? You know, my friends could do it, I could do it too, you know. And them not being there makes me like, inspires me more. Like, you know what, I'm gonna do it, you know, for them as well, you know, try to just do my thing, you know, like they would want me to. With How to Make It, I got that job just being at Supreme in LA. One of the producers always comes shopping at the store, Rob Weiss, and he asked me, like, you look perfect for this character, crazy bipolar skateboarder from New York. And I could relate, because I knew, you know, I knew a bunch of crazy cats like that. You know, like Wilfredo Gomez, that was the name of the character. To act a role like that, skater, ex-pro skater, you know, it was, I could relate to it a lot, so it was a fun experience. Pretty much shout out to everybody back east, you know, in LA, all my Supreme fan, Ammo fam, just everyone out here in Japan for showing a lot of love, and, you know, it's pretty much it. Everybody, y'all know who you are. Yo, yo, what's up? This is Javier Nunez, and you're now rocking with Vhsmag. All right? Peace.